why the New York Knicks are back, fueling the storied franchise to their longest winning streak since 2014. Julius Randle's put up an NBA 11th most 340-plus point games, and the sophomore RJ Barrett has developed into a legit two-way player. This video breaks down every reason for the Knicks' incredible resurgence, and stay tuned to see if they can advance in the playoffs. 15.2% of you watching right now are subscribed, so if you're looking for consistent NBA hot takes, you came to the right place. Quick commenter shout out to Victor, who gives an intuitive take on why Nikola Jokic should be MVP. Appreciate the great answer. Leave your take on the question coming up for a shout out after next video's intro, but let's get into this. RJ Barrett's second season has seen him improve in almost every statistical category, while Julius Randle's taken the reins as the team's number one option and ran with it. We'll get to New York's elite bench backcourt of Derrick Rose and the shockingly impressive rookie Emmanuel quickly, but first, some respect has to be given to the Knicks' top two options, who I just mentioned. The former Laker lottery pick Julius Randle has morphed into a perimeter-scoring menace, as this man has Knicks fans chanting MVP every time he steps to the free throw line. Not just any players built to perform under the pressure that comes along with playing in the mecca of basketball, but Julius has stepped up to the moment and has returned the Knicks to their winning ways that they had going in the early 2010s, and of course back in the 90s with Patrick Ewing. Averaging an NBA most 37.5 minutes per game, Julius has posted career highs across the board and been the main factor to New York having a 34-27 record and sitting fourth in the Eastern Conference as of this recording. Randle's three-point shot is by far the most efficient it's ever been, as he's taking 5 threes per game and knocking down 41% of them. Randle's made 4 or more three-pointers in 10 games this year, while in the first 6 seasons of his career, he had a combined 4 such games. Additionally, Julius has turned himself into a productive 3-level scorer, as 33.2% of Randle's field goal attempts this season have been 2-point pull-ups, and he's connected on a respectable 42% of those opportunities. That ability to stop and pop is such a crucial weapon for Randle because it balances out his power game and allows him to keep the defense guessing. And what makes Julius so tough to stop is how he can hit shots with players directly in his grill. Meanwhile, when backing down, in addition to being 6'8" and 250 pounds of pure muscle, which allows him to bully smaller defenders, Julius is also extremely crafty. From nasty stepbacks and turnarounds to his shifty face-up game, Randle's teammates can trust him to get it done when they toss it to him in the post. Time after time, Randle's shown that he can get it done with even the biggest and toughest of defenders draped all over him. Moving on to the Knicks' 20-year-old second option, RJ Barrett, who was disrespected by being left off ESPN's top 25 players under the age of 25. But Barrett isn't one to be concerned with those kinds of lists, and he's focused on reaching his full potential on the court, and that's about it. And his focus is evidenced by sharp improvement across the board this year. He and his former Duke teammate Zion Williamson are the only two players who are under 21 and posting a true shooting percentage of at least 50%. Another stat that highlights RJ's development is after scoring 20 or more points 13 total times in 56 games when he was a rookie and never reaching the 30-point mark, RJ has already posted 20 or more points 26 times in 60 games, and New York's 17-10 when Barrett scores at least 20. Barrett's scoring, efficiency, playmaking, and defensive all skyrocketed, which has been one of the biggest factors in the Knicks' success. Coming up, you'll see how far RJ and Julius can lead the Knicks in the playoffs.
Playoffs? Don't talk about playoffs!
But this team also has a bunch of talented, well-suited role players ranging from rookies to journeyman vets. As the currently injured LeBron has once said, the league is simply better off when the Knicks are winning. And New York returning to their rightful place in the Eastern Conference has a lot to do with their strong pool of depth. The bench backcourt of Emmanuel quickly and Derrick Rose has torn through opposing defenses this year and has been nothing short of incredible. That was put on full display when the two combined for 40 points off the bench in an overtime thriller to beat the Atlanta Hawks. Quickly can create shots off the dribble and pull up for deep range bombs at a very high level, as he's making 38.7% of his attempts from out there. Meanwhile, the former MVP D. Rose is thriving in his second tenure in New York Threads. It's also his second tenure under coach Tom Thibodeau. Whenever Derek checks into the game, his shot creation makes the team's offense extremely dynamic. He may not have the same speed as he did during his prime, but Rose can still gallop into the lane and knock down shots at a relentless pace. In terms of how he's meshed in the system his coach has laid out for him, Rose told Zach Braziller of the New York Post, quote, "It shows that he's improved as a coach. He's already a great coach, but every year he's improving and adjusting. That's the big difference that I see with him this year. He's giving guys more freedom to go out there and play the way they want. He's being positive on the court." That take from D. Rose was spot on because Tibbs is a Coach of the Year candidate, taking the Knicks from the Dweller of the East into a playoff team. Without the roster changing over last offseason, Tom's taken the Knicks from the 13th ranked defense in 2019-20 to the 3rd ranked defense in 2021. He's gotten the most out of his top two options, and he's also gotten the most out of his former MVP in D. Rose. But one of the biggest luxuries for Tibbs has been the services provided by Nerlens Noel, who's been one of the best role players in the NBA. The former number 6 overall pick in the 2013 draft is averaging a shocking 2.2 blocks per game off the bench, which is so impressive because the man only plays 23.7 minutes per game. If Nerlens keeps up this pace over the final 10 games or so, he'd be the second player of all time to average over 2 blocks per game while not being consistently a part of his team's starting lineup. The only other player to do that is actually Mitchell Robinson, his teammate, who did it last season. Wishing the Block Ness monster M-Rob all the best, another damn valuable role player who actually starts at the small forward for the Knicks is Reggie Bullock. This guy takes 6 threes per game. He knocks down 41% of those shots. Derrick Rose's former teammate in Chicago, Taj Gibson, has stuck around in the league for 13 years for a reason, as the 35-year-old still gives the Knicks 20 minutes of solid energy. And then there's the hyped-up rookie in the product of Dayton University, Obi Toppin. The number 8 pick in 2020's draft has been a tad underwhelming, but he's still become a fan favorite in New York. Obi Toppin's only making 26% of his three-pointers, but him taking that shot in the first place is a very good sign for Knicks fans because he's obviously a big part of their future and you want him spacing the floor and developing that deep-range shot. But the Knicks are about to clinch their first playoff appearance in over half a decade. So, will this team just get swept in the first round, or will they shock the world and make a deep run to the second or third round? One thing's for sure, no matter how many Knicks fans are in the building, MSG's going to be loud as hell and annoying as hell for opposing players. But along with that home court advantage, another thing that really bodes well for the Knicks in the playoffs is the shot creation of Julius Randle. Defenses tighten up significantly in the playoffs, and the teams who don't have that one guy to throw it to and say, "Go get me a bucket," those teams get exposed. As year after year, star power is king. Whether the shot's contested or not, the Knicks' breakout sensation Randle can seamlessly create offense and execute off the dribble by using his elite strength, poise, and handle. Since Randle's days with the Lakers, where his game was extremely raw, he's added a ton of finesse to his offensive repertoire. And you can't forget how crucial the development of RJ Barrett is, whose three-point percentage has gone from 32% in his rookie year to 38% in his sophomore campaign. RJ was overshadowed by Zion and Ja Morant in his rookie season, but now Barrett's proving why he was the 3rd overall pick in the 2019 draft. With 2 legit top scoring options managing the offensive flow for this year and into the future, this young New York team is going to be a force to be reckoned with for many years to come. From their coaching to the back end of their roster, the Knicks also have a ton of playoff experience. Obviously, their top 2 players don't, but the veterans will help them, so I could potentially see them pulling off a first-round upset. But I want to know your favorite part about the Knicks in the comment section. Best answer gets next video shout out. This was D Flow, and I'll see you next video.